In this video, I'm going to show you a very cool method that will make fractions very easy to understand. Now, a fraction contains two numbers, one above the line and one below the line. The numerator is the number on top of the fraction, and the denominator is the number below the fraction. So here's a typical example of a fraction. We have 1/2. Now, the numerator is the 1 that's on the top, and the denominator is the 2 on the bottom. Now, what do these numbers actually stand for? So if we think about pizza, then fractions become a lot easier to understand. So I'm going to draw a pizza down there. Great. Right, actually, that looks great, doesn't it? It looks really good. Pepperoni. Okay, so let's see what the denominator means. Now, we have a 2 for our denominator. And what that tells me is I've sliced my pizza into 2 pieces. So that tells me how many slices I made my pizza into, or how many pieces make up the whole. So in this case, 2 pieces make up the whole pizza. Now imagine if I eat one of those pieces, I've got 1 piece left. The numerator tells me how many pieces I have left. So in this case, I have 1 piece out of 2. I have 1 out of 2, or 1/2 a pizza. Now, a proper fraction is a fraction where the denominator on the bottom is bigger than the numerator on the top. So these fractions, when you work out the decimal, they're actually less than 1. Let's give a typical example. So 3 divided by 4. The numerator is smaller than the denominator, so this is a proper fraction. There's a numerator right there, there's a denominator right there, and there's our pizza. So let's see what this 3/4 means. Now, the 4, remember, tells us how many pieces we're chopping our pizza into. So I've got 4 pieces right there. Let's say I eat one of those pieces. So I've got 3 pieces left, and that's what my numerator tells me, how many pieces I have left. So 3/4 is less than the whole pizza, because proper fractions are less than 1, or less than the whole. Now, 3/4 can also be turned into a decimal. It's simply 3 divided by 4, or 0.75. So that, again, shows us that proper fractions have a value less than 1. How about improper fractions? Well, there's 2 types of improper fractions. One where the numerator and the denominator are the same number, so those would equal 1. Or we have where the numerator is bigger than the denominator. We call those top-heavy fractions. They're still improper fractions, though. All right, let's take a look at the first type. So 4 divided by 4 is an improper fraction because the numerator and the denominator are the same. So let's see what these would mean. Well, the denominator has a 4, so that tells me I'm chopping my pizza into 4 pieces. So 4 pieces are needed to have a whole pizza. Let's see how many pieces I have. Well, the numerator tells me that. I have 4 there. So I have the whole pizza. So 4 divided by 4 is 1. And therefore, that shows me I have 1 whole pizza. Let's have a look at the other type of improper fraction, where the numerator is bigger than the denominator. So in this case, I have my 4 for my denominator, so I'm still chopping my pizza into quarters. And I can see from my numerator here that I have 5 pieces. So I have more than a whole pizza. I actually have 1¼ pizzas there. So 5 over 4 is exactly the same as 1.25, or 1¼ pizzas. So remember, improper fractions are equal to 1 or more. Proper fractions are less than 1. All right, now that 1¼ is an example of a mixed number. So let's talk about mixed numbers. So mixed numbers have a whole part and a fractional part. So in this example, I've got 1¾. The 1 is the whole number, and the 3/4 is a fractional part. Now, the whole number 1 shows me I have 1 whole pizza. And the 3/4 shows me I have an additional 3/4 of a pizza. So when I add these together, I've got 1¾ pizzas. So I've got 1 whole pizza plus the 3/4. Now, since the denominator is 4, that shows we were chopping our pizza into 4 pieces. So I'm going to do the same with that whole pizza right there. I'm just going to slice it into 4 slices. I've still got the whole pizza, because I've got 4 out of those 4 slices, plus the 3 out of 4 from the fractional part. So 4 divided by 4 plus 3 divided by 4, or 4/4 plus 3/4, gives me 7/4. So that tells me I have 7 pieces of pizza, which makes up 1¾ pizzas, or 7 over 4 pizzas. Let's see another example of that. So here we have 2 5/8. So we've got the whole part, which is the 2, that tells me how many whole pizzas I have. So in this case, I've got two whole pizzas right there. I also have 5/8 of a pizza, so that's the fractional part. So I'm going to show in my diagram an additional 5/8 of a pizza. Now, since we're talking about 1/8 of a pizza, chopping them in 8 slices, I'm going to do that with my first two pizzas. So I have 8 slices from the first one, plus 8 slices from the second one, plus the 5 slices from the fractional part. So 8 plus 8 plus 5 gives me 21/8. So 21 over 8. So I've got 21 pieces where 8 would have made a whole pizza. So hopefully you can see how we can turn a whole number into an improper fraction. But of course, in an exam, we don't want to have to draw pizzas. How are we going to do this for a much bigger mixed number? So let's find a method now which uses a very simple equation to turn mixed numbers into improper fractions. So to convert a mixed number into an improper fraction, we're going to use this formula that I'm listing below. Now, it looks scary, but it's actually very straightforward. Okay, so our denominator goes on the bottom there, so we're putting the 4 on the bottom of the fraction. And on the top, we've got the whole number times by the denominator, so 1 times by 4, plus the numerator, so plus 3, gives me 7 over 4. So 1 3/4 is equal to 7 over 4. Pretty straightforward. All right, let's try that with another example. So I'm going to do 2 5/8. We saw this earlier. Let's just prove that the formula will get us to the same answer. So we have our whole number, which is 2, our numerator, which is 5, and our denominator, which is 8. Let's put the denominator on the bottom of the fraction. 2 times 8 plus 5 goes on top, so that gives me 21 over 8. So that's the easy way of converting a mixed number into an improper fraction. All right, how about if we want to do it the other way around? How about if we want to get a mixed number from an improper fraction? So to convert an improper fraction into a mixed number, what we're going to do is we're going to follow the simple steps listed below here. So let's start off with an example, 17 divided by 5. So step number one is divide the numerator by the denominator. So 17 divided by 5 gives me a whole number, which is 3, plus a remainder, which is 2. So 3 times 5 is 15, remainder 2 to get to the 17. Now, step number 2 tells me that when I'm setting up my mixed number here, the remainder becomes the numerator. So I'm going to show that right there. So the 2 goes on top. Now the denominator stays exactly the same as it was before. So the 5 goes on the bottom. And the whole number, the 3, goes in front of the fraction. So we have our mixed number now, 3 2/5. Pretty straightforward. Let's try that with another example. So we have 39 over 7. Now, if you want, you can pause the video here and give this a go to see if you can get the right answer. Okay, good luck. Pause the video and I'll go for the answer in just a few moments. Hey, welcome back. So 7's going to 39. The whole number is 5 times. 5 times 7 is 35, plus a remainder of 4. And when we're setting up our fraction, the numerator is what the remainder is. So that 4 goes on top right there. And the denominator stays the same, so the 7 goes on the bottom. And the 5 goes in front of the fraction now, so we have 5 4/7. Pretty straightforward. Just follow the rules and we get there each time. Now let's talk about equivalent fractions. So equivalent fractions are pretty straightforward as long as we remember this simple rule. If we take any fraction and we multiply the numerator and the denominator by the same number, then we get an equivalent fraction. The value does not change. Let me show that with an example. So I'm picking 3/4 as my fraction here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply the numerator and the denominator by the same number. I can choose any number I want. In this case, I'm choosing 2. So 2 on the top, 2 on the bottom. As long as I'm multiplying by the same number, then the value of this fraction stays the same. Let's prove that. So 3 times 2 gives me 6. 4 times 2 gives me 8. So what I'm trying to show here is 3/4 is exactly the same thing as 6/8. Now, let's use our pizza example to show that this is actually true. 3/4 of a pizza right there, I'm saying that's equal to 6/8 of a pizza. And we can see it's exactly the same thing. The only difference is we have changed the number of slices that we cut our original pizza into. In the first case, we had 4 slices, and we have three out of those four, so three quarters. In the second case, the whole pizza was eight slices, and we've got six of those. So three quarters is exactly the same thing as six eighths. So those are equivalent fractions. Now, I don't need to multiply by 2 over 2 each time. I can multiply by anything, like 10 over 10, 100 over 100. As long as we're multiplying the numerator and the denominator by the same thing, then it doesn't change the value. Now, why is that? If we think about it, 2 over 2 or 10 over 10 or whatever it may be is exactly the same thing as 1. So really what I'm doing is I'm multiplying my fraction by 1. When you multiply by 1, you don't change the value of the fraction. So that's why the value is the same for equivalent fractions. Okay, I'm going to show four more equivalent fractions down here just to give you the idea. So if I start off with 1/2, I can multiply the top and the bottom by 2 to get 2/4, or I could multiply the top and the bottom by 10 to get, say, 10 over 20, or I could multiply the top and the bottom by 50 over 50. So I get 50 over 100 as my answer. All those are equivalent fractions. Now, if you're answering a question and you get, say, 10 over 20 as your answer, what you would want to do is you would want to get it down to its reduced form. So you want the equivalent fraction that's the simplest or the most reduced. In this case, that would be 1 over 2, so 1/2. So what you do is you would take your 10 over 20 and you would try to reduce it down to 1 over 2. Now, let's see how we can reduce fractions then. So we mentioned before that if you have a fraction, you can multiply the numerator and the denominator by the same thing, you don't change the value. It's also true that you can divide both the numerator and the denominator by the same value, and it doesn't change it either. And that's how we actually reduce fractions. So I think it would be easier with an example. So let's start off with 4 over 8. Now, I can divide both the 4 and the 8 by the same number. I'm going to choose 2. So I'm dividing by 2 over 2. So dividing 4 by 2 gives me 2 on the top. Dividing 8 by 2 gives me 4 on the bottom. So what I'm trying to say here is that 2 over 4 is exactly the same thing as 4 over 8. Let's prove this with pizza. I've got 4/8 of a pizza right there. And I'm saying that's the same thing as 2/4 of a pizza. And we can see it's exactly the same thing. All right, now that 2 over 4, I can reduce even further. I can divide the top by 2 and the bottom by 2. So let's do that. I get 1 on the top there and 2 on the bottom. So I'm saying that this is exactly the same as 1/2. And when I draw my pizza in there, you can see it is exactly the same. The only difference is how many slices you've done, but you've got the same amount of pizza. So these are equivalent fractions. The 1/2 is the most reduced. So let's have a look at four more fractions just to show that these are equivalent fractions as well. So let's say I start off with 40 over 60. Now I could reduce these by dividing both by 2. That would give me 20 over 30. Or I could reduce them by dividing by, let's say I've got 20 over 30 now, let's divide top and the bottom by 5. So I get 4 over 6. Now I could divide top and the bottom by 2 to get 2 over 3. So 2 over 3 is exactly the same as all of those other fractions there. It's just that 2 over 3 is the most reduced form. Great, so now let's do a quick summary of the terms that we've learned so far, and then we'll do a quick quiz to see if you can apply this knowledge to it. All right, so some of the basic fraction terms are listed below here. So we have the numerator, that's the top of the fraction. The denominator, that's the bottom of the fraction. A proper fraction is a fraction that has a larger denominator than the numerator. So proper fractions have a value less than 1. So improper fractions have larger numerators. So they either equal 1 or they're greater than 1. Now, equivalent fractions are the same value as each other, and we can reduce them down to the lowest form by dividing the top and the bottom by the same number. And finally, a mixed number is a combination of a whole number plus a fraction. So now it's quiz time. Let's see if we can apply this knowledge to these questions below. So you may want to pause the video here and have a quick go at these, and then I'll go through the answers with you in just a few seconds. Okay, good luck.